My name is Dr. Stephen Theriault, and I have been an infectious disease doctor for the last 20 years. And when I look around the world today, I see much unrest. We see famine, wars, and infectious disease all taking center stage. And honestly, who could forget about COVID? But today I want to talk about a silent killer, one that's been lurking in the background, but we're hearing about more and more every day. The silent killer I'm talking about is antimicrobial resistance, or what we commonly call AMR. Now, what would you think if I told you that 4.6 million people have died of AMR in 2019 alone? Now, let's think about that for a second. That number of deaths is equal to a 747 airplane crashing every 2.5 hours for a year. Think of the government mobilization and the public support when only one airplane crashes. The reason I'm using this analogy today is to show you that not all risks to human life are actually captured in a dramatic event. And if we want to deal with AMR and make sure that there's no more needless deaths, we have to answer the question that everybody here has today. Why are antibiotics not working anymore? In fact, why are antibiotics not working against simple diseases like urinary tract infection diseases in women or prostatitis in men? And what can we actually do about it? Well, let's start with antibiotics. People are surprised when I tell them that 70% of all of our antibiotics are actually used to grow our food. From giving our chickens high-grade antibiotics so they can get to a sellable weight, or spraying Florida orange trees with antibiotics in order to remove citrus greening, which is a bacterial infection which actually causes oranges to shrivel up and turn green. These usages, as well as the indiscriminate use of antibiotics in our healthcare system, have created an infectious disease time bomb. Now, let me stop here for a second and let me explain what I mean by a time bomb. When we use antibiotics in our food systems and when we stop taking our antibiotic medications, the bacteria in our body are exposed to low levels of antibiotics. Because those antibiotics are at low levels, the bacteria can learn how to grow with that antibiotic. This is where resistance starts. And honestly, it only gets worse from there. The bacteria will continue to grow with that antibiotic, becoming so resistant that that antibiotic will no longer be effective. Mix that with the worldwide overuse of antibiotics, as well as globalization, and we've created a situation where resistant bacteria are replicating faster than any other time in our human history. In fact, the World Health Organization, or the WHO, predicts that by 2050, now this is only 26 years away, but by 2050, AMR will be the leading cause of death worldwide. That's an estimated 10 million more deaths, all being done by antimicrobial resistance. Now, with AMR becoming such a worldwide issue, what can we actually do? Well, let me be clear. To deal with AMR, we require a multi-pronged approach. And today, I want to talk about one of the most promising approaches. Bacteriophage. They strikingly look like a lunar lander or something from a Hollywood horror story, especially if they were 10 feet tall. It's amazing, though, that you can fit millions of them just on the tip of a pen. In fact, they are the most abundant biological entity that nobody has ever heard of. In fact, you have billions of them all over your body right now. And if your neighbor beside you actually looked at you with an electron microscopy glasses, you would be teeming with viruses. And they're brilliant viruses. They only infect bacterial cells. They don't infect human cells, animal cells, or plant cells. They're Mother Nature's natural way for dealing with bacterial populations. Now, with AMR becoming such a worldwide problem, what can we do? As well, bacteriophage have an interesting history. They were first discovered by Félix Delarel, a French-Canadian, who in World War I was actually treating soldiers with a mystical liquid that was actually curing dysentery. Now, in 1918, scientists had no idea what the cure was because viruses were just being discovered. Move forward 10 years, and antibiotics were discovered. From there, bacteriophage were generally forgotten worldwide. Fast forward to today, though, where molecular genetic techniques manufacturing techniques, as well as a better understanding of how viruses actually work, we are now able to start creating solutions to try to deal with our antimicrobial problems. So I'm sure many of you have heard of stories of bacteriophage being used to actually treat patients. These patients have, again, no other medical countermeasures that they can actually use to actually treat their disease. And they're looking for an alternative solution that they can use to save their lives. Today, I want to focus in on one particular story. Picture this. You're healthy. You're a runner. You enjoy nature. You love taking hikes. You're basically enjoying all parts of your life. Then bang, you have an accident. And now you need surgery. But not a simple surgery, an actual prosthetic joint replacement surgery. And from there, you go through surgery, and like many other people who have gone through prosthetic joint surgeries, you end up catching a bacterial infection, one that is antimicrobial resistant. From there, you go through repeated surgeries as well as repeated antibiotic treatments to try to save your life. Well, this was the reality for Taya, an inspiration to us all, and the first Canadian to actually be treated with a bacteriophage solution to treat her prosthetic joint infection. Now, let me slow down here a little bit and tell you how we actually helped Taya. So as some of you may have guessed, I run a bacteriophage company called Cytophage, and we do amazing work there with bacteriophage. But let's save those scientific details for a different TED Talk. Today, let's focus on Taya's story. So a few months back, I was approached by the Ottawa Hospital to see if we could help with dealing with a very progressive prosthetic joint infection in one of their patients. Taya had gone through numerous surgeries as well as numerous antibiotic treatments in order to treat a very nasty bacterial infection that was resistant to all types of antibiotics. Her only medical options, unfortunately, were losing her leg to amputation or dying from the disease. So luckily, the doctors at Ottawa Hospital reached out to us and asked us if we could help. So I pulled my team together and we created a solution, a bacteriophage solution. We sent it to Ottawa Hospital for them to administer. I got to stop here for a second. I'm making this sound really simple, but I have to be honest, it's not that easy. It takes a lot of effort and a lot of time to create these solutions. And I want to applaud the Ottawa Hospital doctors, because if it wasn't for them, Taya would have never received this life-saving treatment. The Ottawa Hospital doctors had to aggressively discuss with the government regulators to ensure that we could actually treat Taya and save her life. Now, the monitoring time for Taya is still ongoing, and I'm excited to say that she's doing really well. She's got increased mobility, decreased swelling, and honestly, she's a great spokesperson for bacteriophage therapy in Canada. Now, Taya's story sounds like it's going to be a great success. And there have been other bacteriophages that have been used to save lives as well as to stop amputations. But there's still thousands of people out there that are looking for an alternative solution in order to treat some of their antimicrobial resistant bacterial infections. And today, I want to share some of these stories with you guys. Like Dale, a retired pilot who should be enjoying his golden years of retirement, but unfortunately has suffered from prostatitis for the last 15 years. Now, prostatitis is a very painful disease. In discussions with Dale, he would always talk about his pain levels. On a good day, his pain level would be a 4 to 5. On a bad day, though, it would be a 7 to 9. Now, I'm sure many of you in the audience have had some type of pain affliction, and you can understand that having pain levels at this level, it would really make it hard to have a normal life. And with no antibiotic solution in sight for Dale, possibly a bacteriophage could be his solution. Now, there's one thing that I always am reminded of when I think of Dale. It's something that made me understand where he was coming from. He would always say to me, "Stephen, if I could have one pain-free day, it would be worth any cost." Just think about that. One pain-free day. Any cost. You know, with the realization that the damage that antimicrobial resistance is having on our population, it's hard not to see the human side of these diseases. And tragically, Rose, who was suffering from a very bad urinary tract infection, and unfortunately she passed away before the bacteriophage therapy that was created for her could actually be administered. So to share the gravity of the problem, that company that I talked about earlier, where again, we create AMR solutions for humans, as well as trying to deal with the 70% antibiotic issue in animals. But we're a small Canadian company, and I get hundreds of requests to actually create solutions and cures for Canadians, as well as other people around the world. But we require regulatory bodies, as well as government bodies, as well, we need to understand that if we're going to have an innovative science like this, we need to have some type of investment to push that science forward to make it successful. So, on the backs of these stories, and the understanding that if we are to deal with our problems with AMR, we're going to have to change our strategies. I have a simple ask for everybody here in the room today. And this ask is this. Look up bacteriophages. Check out the great things that are happening in the world of bacteriophage research. Talk to your friends and families about bacteriophages. And more importantly, next year, when all of those politicians come to your place banging on your door and asking you for your vote, you tell them bacteriophage research needs to be funded in order to propel this great science forward. And if you have a bacterial infection, ask your doctor if a bacteria therapy would work for you. Now, we live in a world of escalating problems. Some of them we will never have solutions for. But we have a great start at solving the problems with antimicrobial resistance. And the greatest and best impact that we can all have is to ensure that people understand that bacteriophages can be an alternative solution to antibiotics. And once we do that, we can start saving lives. Thank you.